You know, Christmas.
Christmas is fast and approaching. I am so excited. The most wonderful time of the year is rapidly approaching. Oh, Christmas time is just such... Like, I know this sounds very cliche, but honestly, Christmas is such a beautiful time of the year. From the music, from the decor. Trust me, I still love Halloween, but, you know, around Christmas time, like, as soon as November 1st, I'm... Well, actually, like, a couple days, like, November 4th, I really get into my Christmas spirit. Like I am now. I'm wearing garland as a scarf, which is actually really irritating on my neck, so I'm gonna just put this over here, and, yeah, so, as you can already tell, Jace is not here. That's unfortunate, but, you know, he will be back. He's not leaving the show, trust and believe. Just busy at the moment. So, in honor of the season, we are going to be making sugar cookies. But not just any kind of sugar cookies. Sugar cookies topped with crushed candy cane bits. Yeah, I know it's not that special, but you know what? It's better than all the other Christmas specials I've done. Remember the season 3? Of course you don't, because nobody watches this shit. Well, I don't know, maybe one day. But anyways, let's get into the ingredients. Alright, so what you're gonna need for this is we're gonna be using the Betty Crocker sugar cookie mix. And we're going to be following the drop cookie method, but the ingredients you'll need for the drop cookie method are one egg. One egg. I actually forgot something in here. Hold on. I need half a stick of butter. As you can see, you know, they make... Wait, isn't this like a quarter though? This is not weight. This is not half. Oh, wait, no, these aren't half. Well, I don't know if it's half in the way they want. Well, it says one half on the fucking box, so you know what? Yeah. And the ingredients you'll need for after is frosting and crushed peppermint candies. Peppermint. Yeah. How do I wipe my lips to shit on it? Anyways. So, and obviously the tools you'll need for this are a bowl, a whisker, whatever, and obviously a tray, you know what the fuck I mean, Alright,
I'm just gonna voice over the rest of this because you can't hear me, and most of it's just mumbling to myself. But besides that, so first, well, obviously you're gonna dump all of your shit into a bowl, and then you're gonna put in a stick of melted butter and an egg. And, you know, you're gonna mix and all that, but the problem that I had with this is that it was still very dry. Like, it was just clumped up balls of dry... shit. See, like, I was setting that up because, you know, I didn't really think this would be that difficult, but, you know, it just didn't go the way I wanted. And you're going to see that right here. I had to speed it up because I just want to get the shit over with. But as you can see, I was having quite a problem with it, so, yeah. And then I tried, you know, mixing it with my hands. I got some gloves and just started mixing it, but that wasn't helping too because the shit was just getting stuck to the gloves. So, yeah, I tried mixing it with a regular spoon, that didn't work. I tried mixing it with a mixer, that didn't work. Tried mixing it with my hands, also didn't work. So, I just had to resort to, I don't know, plan, whatever. And I cut it out, but I put some water in there. I actually put a little bit too much, which is probably why it turned out bad. But I put water in there. And, I started mixing that around, and it actually made it better. And then I think it made it more worse when I put in a little bit too much of vanilla extract because I forgot that vanilla extract doesn't come in like a squeeze thing like the food coloring things does. Which honestly, I honestly feel like that they should just do like those squeeze things for the... I don't know why I lost my train of thought, but they should do like the fucking vanilla extract. Like, they need to put the vanilla extract in like those squeeze bottles, because I feel like that would make it more easier and not have you fuck it up, you know. And then I put some red food dye in it to make it, you know, a little more Christmassy, you know. Sorry if I sound tired. It's just, this was just a long, exhausting process just for it to turn out like shit. You'll see what I mean. Anyways, then I sprayed the pan after all that with some olive oil. Then, you know, I started dumping them in tablespoons equally, or not, well, not that equally on the pan, which this also probably contributes to why they turned out like shit, but you know what? I didn't really expect it to be that much of a flop. You know, I actually did try making sugar cookies. This was actually a scrap cooking with a person episode, and I'm gonna just tell you on that there was gonna be a sugar cookie marshmallow episode, and it's basically as it sounds like marshmallows inside of the sugar cookies. But when I took it out, the marshmallows were dissolved, and it was just a big glob of shit. So yeah. And so, you know, when the timer was done, I put my cookies in the oven and everything was great. And as I was doing my dance break, you know, I kind of had to retake the dance break a couple times because, you know, I kept fucking up the choreograph. But as I was recording, the timer went off, and so I went to check on them to pull them out, and,
Hi, updates. So, as I was filming my dance break segment, the timer for the cookies went off. And, so I went to go, I was just gonna go pull them out and then just go back to, you know, filming it. You know, maybe I should have not had the water or the butter, the extra stick of butter. Like, oh my.
I'm so tired of being here.
And so, as I was, you know, thinking about jumping off a bridge, an excellent idea came to me.
I'm turning these into cake balls. Look at that, and I'm not even fit. I still have a lot of cake mix left to go. Or cookie, cake mix, whatever. Not cookie cake, but, you know what I mean, it's, no, it's cake mix, so. But, you know, I could go from fucking up something completely and being a dumbass bitch to finding a solution quick. Sometimes, not all times, but in those moments, it just makes the problems go away, you know, not all the problems, but you know, it's good, yeah. It's Christmas time, let's be happy, if we, well, even though some of us can't, but try to be, you know, lift other spirits. Anyways, so if you've always wondered how to make cake pops, so now this went from cooking cookies, sugar cookies, to cake pops. I just think I can't make sugar cookies. I just think, like, I can't make sugar cookies from scratch. And that is honestly really bad because I wanted to join, like there's this, like, program. It's like a college-esque type thing. I don't know if I should name it because I really don't. I mean, I don't know a lot of people watch this, but it's like, you know, there are freaks in the internet. But, like, like, it's like this college, it's not really college, but it's like, well, it's more fun than college. But anyways, it's like this thing where they have like these different programs, you can probably figure out for yourself. And basically they have like all this other stuff, they have like a baking pastry thing there. And I wanted to do that. Well, you know what they say, practice makes perfect. And you know what, maybe one day I can make sugar cookies without fucking it up. But it was probably because they added the water, but like, how the fuck, like, it's just, I don't know what I did wrong before the water. If an expert chef is watching this, which I highly doubt, but if anyone that knows any knowledge, let me know, but, yeah. But anyways, back to what I was saying. If you're wondering how cake pops are made, well, I mean, it's pretty simple and everyone knows it, but basically, like, you know, you cook cake mix, like, regularly, and then, like, you take it out, put it in a bowl, and then, you know, get your frosting, get, like, put some frosting, put a lot of frosting on there. Well, not, like, a lot, but, like, a decent amount, and then, you know, mix it around, and, you know, you basically get this, like, something, like, formable. It's, like, edible Play-Doh, you know, well, Play-Doh is edible in itself, well, not really, but, you know, people still ate it anyways. I never did, but, probably did, who the fuck knows, I don't know, it's, It's been 16 years. Anyways, so then, you know, roll them into ball form. Well, I'm not really making cake pops because, like, I don't have the sticks, but I'm just, it's just more cake balls, you know, like I said earlier, so. But, yeah, so I'm just, you know, you're gonna roll, obviously, roll your balls out. And then, yeah, so, like, as you can see, some of them are gonna be a little bit, bigger than the others, but, I'm disgusting. So, basically, you know, you take, you know, you just take, like, a handful, or, like, the size of your palm, and, you know, roll it out. Ooh, this one's not working good. Yeah, this one is a little bit crumbly. Don't know why that is, but yeah. That's all. Alright, so, I don't have, because I also forgot to mention that I don't, obviously for cake pops, you, like, they put chocolate over it, or, like, white chocolate or whatever, you know, cover everything, like how a cake pop should be. So, I don't have the candy melts to do that right now. Hopefully, if my dad didn't forget, well, I don't think he did, because he went to the store when I called him. Because I texted him first and then I called him. But that was before, because I was calling him because I wanted to know what time he would be home, because, you know, anyways. But, yeah, so hopefully he didn't forget. I don't know what the fuck he is, but he should be home soon, so. Yeah, so, you know, I made these, so, yeah. And then, so once he gets home, you know, I'm gonna melt the chocolate, put it on there, and then we're gonna freeze it, and then. Alright, so I'll see you in a few. Be right back. Alright, so now it is 5:32, so. It's dark outside, so now, once you finally get your white coating wafers, or candy coating, chocolate, whatever, you're gonna put them in a microwave for, I don't know, I just had it on a random set, random times, it took quite a while, I don't know, but, you know, once they're melted like this, then, I'm just gonna take, oh, no, that's not gonna work, they're still too brittle to fucking, I'm just gonna have to do it like this, I guess. It burns. It burns. See. Wow. There's one that got loose. Well, let me see if I can just break these apart real quick. Yeah. Okay, it's kind of hard to break somebody. Like, there's just chocolate every fucking corner. Is this the one that has released it? Here goes nothing. Well, yeah.
My pool is just papa, but it's good.
Well, that is it. I hope you guys have a very Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays, depending on what you celebrate. Thank you so much for watching this. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell. Please do. Share these videos. And I will see you guys in the new year.
She's such a fucking bitch.
She's not.
And you are too, and you're a fucking cuck.
You take.
You have no fucking backbone.
Alright, you should leave. We'll talk later. Yeah, you should get out.
I am going, but yeah. We're not talking later.